Hi there, ice and mixed climbers. Today I'm going to show you how you can turn a pair of used ice skates into a mixed climbing or dry tooling shoe, or fruit boot as they're sometimes known. There's a couple of considerations that you need to think of before you do it. One is to get a boot that fits your foot really well, obviously, leaving enough room for socks, like thick socks for the winter, and also a boot that's quite stiff in the sole. Once you take the blade off of it, it becomes a little more flexible, but as I'll show you later, there is a way to stiffen up the sole without adding too much weight. Any crampon with a vertical front point will work. These cyborgs here are really nice. You just run them in a mono point configuration and to bolt them onto your boot. So yeah, that's pretty much all there is to getting started, and let's do it. So the first thing we want to do is grind off the rivets that hold the blades onto the bottom of the skate. There's probably a lot of different ways you can do that. I'm just going to use a drill with a grinding wheel on it. Safety first. So once you take the heads down, the plate will just pop off like that, and then you can just knock the remaining rivet through into the inside of the boot. Blades off. Here's the bottom of the skate. You just have to grind these rivet heads down a little bit more and then punch them right through, and they'll fall out the inside. So this skate here is still pretty stiff without the blade, and it won't require any support. Another layer here. We're just going to be able to bolt the crampon directly to it. Yeah, that's a nice stiff skate. Okay, so I've ground the blades off, and that leaves a bunch of holes in the bottom of the skate. So the next step is going to be to fill those holes in with some silicone. Just regular 100% silicone works fine. Put a little dab in each hole. Like that, just to keep the elements out, the water, ice, cold, smooth it down, and do that for all the holes. So I picked up a pair of Gravel G14 crampons. These will work fine for making a pair of dry tooling boots. They've got dual front points, but it's easy enough to swap them or change them into a mono. And they have a flat
metal structure as opposed to a vertical one. It's horizontal, so they'll bolt easily onto the base of your shoe, and they'll stay nice and flush. So the first step is to disassemble them. Obviously, you got to take the bail off, take the connecting bar off, the heel bail comes off, and then you end up with two pieces, the toe assembly with the front points. I've already taken that apart, and then the heel assembly. And I'm thinking for this particular pair, probably going to chop these right across here. Four points plus the mono up front is going to be enough. I don't think we need these two in the center. And probably, I'm still not sure whether I want to mount this on the heel or just go without anything on the heel, so that we have a boot that looks like that with nothing on the heel. The great thing about this is you can always mount it, drill it, mount it, and try it. If you want to change it, it's easy enough to unbolt and fill the holes in again with silicone. So yeah, that's step two. On to the circular saw with the metal cutoff blade. So right now I'm going to cut off some of the extra metal off of these G14 crampons, like this tab right here that centers the heel. With the crampons bolted to the boot, we're not going to need that. As well as I decided that these four points plus the mono point are going to be enough, and I don't need this stuff at the back. So I'm going to zip it across here and here to get rid of that. And to do that, I'm going to use a circular saw with a metal cutting blade. As you can see, that works pretty good. Now I'll just take a file to these sharp edges, round them off a little bit. We're good to go. Now with the crampon parts on the boot, you can go ahead and mark the crampons where you'll drill them. For this setup here, I'm going to drill four holes in the front. So we've drilled out the crampons, four holes, one, two, three, four in the front point assembly, and two holes and the pinhole in the rear crampon assembly. Next, what we'll do is
set the crampon on the appropriate shoe or boot, line it up so the front point sticks straight forward and is extended as much as you would like it to be. I think between an inch and a half is good. And then when you have it where you want it, mark through the holes in the crampon onto the sole of the boot. And finally, you drill the holes in the boot. Now we'll place one of the bolts through the hole in the sole with the head on the inside, and the nut will go on the bottom. I chose these metal screws with a round head, so you're less likely to feel it under your foot. And it's kind of awkward to work in here, so needle nose pliers seem to help out a bit. Here we go. And once you have one bolt through, you can thread a nut on it just to hold it in place while we drill out the other holes. So after fixing the bolts and nuts to the bottom of your shoes through the crampons, you might find that it's difficult to tighten, to get in there and tighten the bolt heads because of the toe piece on your boot is in the way. You can't quite get to it. So what I've done here, you figure out about where the head comes through. In this case, somewhere around right here. Mark it. And then drill it. Once it's drilled, you should be able to get the screwdriver in there. Just like that. And then tighten. If you have to hold the nut, these needle nose pliers work pretty well. That way you can get all these
bolts cranked nice and tight. And then with the holes in your boot, a little bit of silicone. A little bit of silicone, dab in there. Good as new. Now a little bit of silicone on the holes. Just to fill them in. Keep the cold out. And any water or moisture. And now I'm gonna just sharpen up the points. And we'll be ready to climb. So I mentioned earlier that depending on the boot you're using, you might need to stiffen up the outsoles. This pair of CCM Cyclone skates are pretty stiff. There's a bit of flex to them, but I think they'll be okay. On the other hand, this pair of, I don't even know what they are, Delta, old leather skates, had quite a soft outsole. So what I did was I glued on some of this material here to the base. I cut it to shape the sole, just traced it and then cut it with a jigsaw. It's called Macrolon, and it's a polycarbonate, apparently good to minus 200 degrees, so it's quite a durable material. And it's very stiff too. It comes in different thicknesses. This stuff looks like it might be about 7 mil thick, but you can buy it thinner. And I just bought a scrap piece this size here. It was only, I think, $3, $4. And then I used some regular epoxy glue to stick it to the skate outsole. That stiffens it up quite well. This is actually a really stiff pair of boots now. So the Fruit boots are finished now. The last thing I did was to put some new laces on them, and also to put a insole down in the bottom there. Just one of these reflective bottom felt top dollar store insoles, I think, adds a little bit of warmth. And also you could cover them to keep them a little bit warmer. What I did with my pair was I got some cycle shoe over boots, and I slipped them down the front. They had a zipper in the back, but nothing in the front. So I slipped them down the front and just sewed a zipper in. And on the bottom, I cut a hole out for the heel points. The front points already had the hole for the clips for the pedal. And slid those on. And it does help. It adds a couple of degrees of warmth, I think. The other thing you can do, or what we did, is when we bought when we bought the skates for my wife from a thrift store, they came with these fuzzy figure skating over boots. They already had a zip down the front, so that worked perfectly. So when they're on, you got something like this. I guess not for everybody, but my wife likes them, and she seems to get a lot of comments and compliments when she's out at the crag with them. Yeah, they probably don't add a lot of warmth, but a little bit, I think, anyway. And finally, a lot of the information that I got
I couldn't find anything online, but I did find some information in Sean Isaac's mixed climbing guide and also in Will Gadd's Ice and Mixed Climbing. There's a page or two in each of these books regarding building your own fruit boots. It's good information. So I think that about wraps it up. Let's go try them out.
Shouldn't have been a messin', and now someone else is getting all your best. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. Yeah. You keep lying when you ought to be truthing, and you keep losing when you ought to not bet. You keep saying when you ought to be a-changing. Now what's right is right, but you ain't been right yet. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. You keep playing where you shouldn't be playing, and you keep thinking that you'll never get burned. I just found me a brand new box of matches, yeah. And what he knows you ain't had time to learn. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. Are you ready, boots? Start walking.